he'll prove anything. These ain't that bad. Who is that?
Alright, fellas, let's get this shit going. Keep it simple, fellas. Keep it simple. Get that easy.
And Paul George just run up in front of me like, yo, I can't be the GOAT.
Let's go, baby.
Yeah, you know, Kill'll be tripping.
Yeah. Yep.
Ready! Ready? Okay. Thank you.
What up?
next for Ben Simmons?
Ooh. Ben Simmons, I think he got a modeling career coming up.
I can see that.
You can see that?
I can see that.
Yeah, I think he'll do great in France.
He definitely is far to get out for.
Did we mention him in that? Yeah, he's definitely in the get out crew.
He's next generation.
Yeah, he's next generation get out. Him and Kuzma.
Yeah.
But Kuzma's still balling.
No, Kuzma. Kuzma messed with my homie Wendy Hall.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Benny. Yeah, he out of there.
We're gonna blaze up till Cuz ready.
Seriously, because you're not doing anything to really better yourself when your contract is up.
I think Cuz still out smoking.
Anything that you should be getting. And I'm trying to figure out where would you fit in.
Yeah, where would you trade them to? What would you do with them at this point? You can't even get much for them, the money they spent on them.
Right. I mean,
I don't know how many years left he has on his contract.
But
whatever it is.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is this, right? Ben Simmons is still young.
Yeah.
So the fact that he's going to be up for a new contract soon, find out when his contract is up. He's going to be up for a new contract soon. You're damaging that. These niggas are going to grab 250, 260, about to be 270. You might be in the, we got
13. It's kind of like the same thing that happened with Markelle Fultz. He's in Orlando, he's balling, but I still need to see him shoot.
Y'all fans in Philly fuck these niggas mentally up.
Because I was thinking about it, that was two back-to-back, because I remember when Ben Simmons was cheering for Markelle Fultz, and now it's the same thing. It's crazy.
Y'all put a lot of pressure on your athletes to be mentally breaking them, and just fucking them up. Even when they leave.
Yeah,
so,
for
know,
real.
I think
we'll go for a little bit more. Put him on the training next time.
That's the kid named from Duke, the same thing. I didn't see him play well, I think, left for me as well. Okafor or something like that.
I don't remember his situation, but Markel Fultz and, what's his name? When's his contract up?
Yeah, so to answer your question, 2019 rolled around, Simmons signed a max rookie extension worth $177 million. So it ties into the franchise until 2024-2025 season.
Yeah, he's
that's funny.
2024-2025.
Yeah, he said, I'm mentally drained.
Yeah, and secondly, don't be more.
All right.
Don't be more.
Boy, Ray.
So he's still got two more years.
Damn, fuck. Try to recreate that real game, baby.
That makes sense.
Or join the light skin team.
Not the light skin team. Okay. So, also speaking of NBA, obviously we're in playoffs right now. E-40 made headlines after he got escorted out of his seat by a security official as he argued with Kings fans in the stands. He said racial bias led to his ejection. What do you think?
E-40 was ejected?
He said racial bias led to him being escorted out.
Was that San Francisco? Was
that Kings?
Was it Sacramento?
Oh, they were supposed to do that. It was just another blow, pause to the organization and say, we really want to rock this back.
E-40
is a Golden State legend as a fan, so it was a way to just disrespect them a little bit more.
I don't think they should have did that, because first of all...
They shouldn't have done it.
Yeah, because first of all, some G shit. Look, the NBA, if you look at these games around the league, I'm talking about, you could count probably every night on one hand how many black faces you're going to see outside of Memphis, Charlotte.
Yeah.
You know, them black faces around on the floor seats, black people don't get them seats, and half the arena is majority white, depending on where you're at. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, when you have a black face on the floor, people don't always like that. Whether he's a mega super fan or not, I don't know where his situation
is. He's a superstar.
Yeah, I don't know if he's in a situation with Golden State if they give him tickets or not. But them season tickets,
that's
just $300,000-$400,000 a year. And that's not even Golden State. I'm talking about other prices that I paid for. When I'm talking Golden State, that should make me $700,000-$800,000 a year to see 41 games, including the playoffs. I'm pretty sure even at four seats that play Sacramento, they had to pay for the seat.
Yeah.
Somebody heckles you for three quarters, and you turn around and address them, then you get kicked out.
Yeah.
I think what you're saying is like, that's like getting the biggest fan out of here.
Fuck that.
But at the same time, this man spent his money.
Mm-hmm.
You know he's a super duper fan. Would you have done that for somebody who's white?
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, they should have done it. I'm just saying that's probably why they did it.
Where the fuck homeboy at, man?
With the best outfits, you know, doing what he does.
That's 41. And then on top of that, 40 motherfucking is a super duper. Like, a lot of people know he selling records out his trunk at one time. Then he moved on after. He's been doing fucking music. Him and Too Short are so fucking underrated.
I take that back. He's never supposed to be disrespected ever in California. That's California. I ain't think about it like that.
Sacramento is 30, 45, 50 minutes from the Bay. All he did was drive down the road.
Yeah, they know better than that. Sacramento, y'all know better than that.
Yeah, you validated my nigga. So, a lot of people like Ice-T, Too Short, E-40, because we from the East Coast, we're not supposed to say we. Too Short been out since 1982. You look at the movie, you don't even know. You look at the movie,
you know.
You check out the movie Breaking, and you don't believe it, because I just felt that when I was Ice-T is the DJ in the movie.
How you know I don't know that?
You know that?
Can't, you know.
Which Breaking, one or two?
I don't have time.
E-40 should not have been disrespected, and I think he did a lot for that area, whether it's Sacramento, the Bay,
California,
period. He puts them on their back. A lot of times, the Bay Area artists don't get the respect they deserve because they're not from L.A. Everybody was going to play on the longevity up there in the Bay. NBA had some. Get that shit together.
Yeah, bro.
Got you feeling like an option. We are situated about 8 miles west of New York City at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford. Tonight, it's the Sunday night opener of the 2023 NFL season, as it'll be the Dallas Cowboys taking on the New York Giants. Up for our first Sunday nighter of the year, the Cowboys and Giants underway in week one. And no run back on this one, so the new season will begin at the 25-yard line. Start the drive with a carry by Jones. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. That's a pickup of 11 and a first down on their first offensive play.
Coming in, he really liked his chance of having a big year based on a terrific offseason. And runs like that on opening weekend show that he's right.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9. Absolutely no trouble moving the ball on the ground on the first two plays from scrimmage.
Absolutely. You know what I really like? Same guy carrying the ball in both plays. And what drives me crazy is when a back has a nice run, he taps his helmet to go out of the game. I would want the ball again and again and again because you've established really nice momentum. And now you're seeing the field really well.
And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A big chunk on the ground there, 27 yards. They had a chance to limit his yardage, but he was able to fight off that tackle.
So it's not just the responsibility of the guys who missed the tackles along the way. It's all 11 on defense, able to stop this guy, unable to do it on that play. They've got to find a way. How about his ability to break through and gain that yardage?
And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. Now a 2nd and 2. Staying on the ground with Vaughn. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now they go from 2nd and 2 to a tough 3rd and 4.
Well, they've had success on the ground on this drive, and that makes the defense more likely to overcommit to stop the run as they did on that play. But keep in mind, it makes them susceptible to play-action passes as well.
Here's a diving catch right side. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
That's a big conversion there on 3rd down, and this has been a great opening drive. You know, at this point, they'd hate to settle for 3, but they've created a fresh set of downs and a 1st and goal.
First and goal, a good chance for our first touchdown of the new season. Jones. He is going nowhere in a hurry as he is going to lose yardage here in a big way. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
Did your high school have that same push them back cheer?
I was a kicker.
Well, it certainly worked. Didn't matter whether we were kickers or not. That one worked, didn't it? They pushed him back at his last snap of the ball, and boy, they created a nice play for themselves. Would they lose three on that one?
Yeah, from the one back to the four. They'll try again with Jones. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
We all know how much running backs love getting the ball down near the goal line. They think they're going to find a way into the end zone. He hasn't had that kind of luck so far. Ends up not getting in on the last two carries. You know he's going to be...
And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Kayvon Thibodeau. Breaks through the contact.
Good shit, Carl.
And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Giants touchdown.
So just a tremendous play there defensively on this opening drive. Not just to make the interception, but to take it all the way home.
And it felt like this was a defense that was on its heels a bit to start this thing off.
Yeah, they pretty much let the other guys march right down the field until that moment.
Yeah, key play there.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
You gotta make up for that, bro.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And one of the things we like to hit on every year are the new rule changes. So we got a few for 2023. A lot are procedural, having to do with deadlines and roster construction and such. But two kind of caught my eye, Charles. One is the option to fair catch a kickoff and have it come out to the 25 like it does in college. You like that?
I don't like it at all. I don't like it in college. I don't like it in the NFL. I want to have something different, and I really wanted the special teams coach to be a little bit more involved. But I do understand why the league is doing it. They believe it promotes safety, and it's hard to argue against that.
What about, this is the other one, guys can now wear the number zero. We've already seen some make the switch, Calvin Ridley, DeAndre Swift, Braxton Berrios, amongst others.
Yeah, and you know something, when you see those guys make that move, expressionism for these guys, and I love it. I just think we didn't go far enough. What about a double zero like Jim Otto used to wear or Kenny Burrow used to wear? Let's add that back to the NFL jerseys.
With
it is Jackson. 8 yards on the return following a punt of 41. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. Good starting field position for the New York Giants here as they come up first and 10 at the 40. Now Jones. They'll roll him out right. His first throw of the season is intercepted. And the return stops at the 39-yard line.
Well, Charles, you got a quarterback out of the pocket, trying to make a play, and you get it, but instead he ends up throwing it to the other team.
And partners, we know to be successful in this league, number one, you're going to have to be able to make plays on the perimeter or when the pocket breaks down. But number two, you've got to make smart decisions with the football. And that time, that simply was not a smart decision.
Carlos Basham able to make the play defensively.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Line, 2nd and 9. Again, it's Jones. Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. Only gets 3 yards there on the heels of the 1-yard pickup. Sets up 3rd and 6.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, Not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. The Cowboys on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Now Prescott. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it with an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. A chance for their 1st points of the season here as it's 1st and goal. Now Jones. And the second wing of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. A loss of 2 there, 2nd down.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on their early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
Second down, Prescott feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. Bobby Okereke running in and bringing him down. The Giants going to go ahead and use the 1st of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this 2nd quarter.
Big
play if you think about it right now in this season opener. It's 3rd and goal. Now Prescott. Touchdown, Ronald Jones, a 7-yard touchdown grab, and the Cowboys are an extra point away from evening this one up.
Well, that's what I call an answer right there. They gave up a sack on the previous play. How about what they did to finish things off, turning it right back around?
That's the response, and that O-line feels a lot better now, don't they?
Yeah, without a doubt, because give up the sack on the previous play, that just hurts those guys because they never want to see their guy get hit.
The extra point up and good, and we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This taken in right around the goal line. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very 1st play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football, and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
2nd down, here's Barkley again. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 11 and a Giant 1st down. Throwing Jones. Eluding the pressure right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now they'll bring up 2nd down.
And a smart play there. He's probably saying, I wish I would have done that in the last drive instead of throwing the interception.
Here's 2nd and 10. Jones fakes the give to Barkley. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the 1st down marker. The improv act there, good for 9, and now they'll be looking at a 3rd and short, 3rd and 1.
Certainly not the way they drew it up in the playbook, but that's why they love this guy back there. He sees things breaking down, and he's more than capable of finding an escape route and still getting a decent gain.
They'll try to run for it with Barkley. And he's going to have a 1st down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. second quarter. 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third. First down, Jones. Got a man open. It's Darren Waller. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. They go back to the ground now with Barkley. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Boy, I tell you, the schedule makers got it right here in week one. A lot of great games today. And another Buffalo and the Jets right here in this very stadium tomorrow night. Won't that be fun? But of these two teams, Charles, Giants and Cowboys, which one do you think is the bigger threat to Philadelphia in the NFC East?
Bang.
As we start here right now, it's got to be Dallas. How explosive are they offensively? Extremely. And on the defensive side of the ball, they take it away from teams. But don't count out the Giants. Their defense, they get out to a lot of pressure. If their quarterback continues to grow, look out.
The Giants go on fourth, but come up empty. And this 10-play drive winds up yielding nothing. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And we'll see what they want to do. 45 seconds is all that remains until the break. Now a man who's taking the reins with the Cowboys, it's Tony Pollard. And he'll work this back to right around the line of scrimmage and surrender there. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Second and 10. Throwing, Prescott.
Ooh.
Looking for Cooks, and it's intercepted. It's Deontay Banks with it. And he'll take this back down inside the 20. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Off the play fake. Jones. That's caught. It's Waller. Touchdown, Giants. From 19 yards away. And the Giants will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point by York is up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. The kicking team out there for the Giants as they will send this one away. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They'll come up now second and 4 from the 31. Final play of the half, Prescott. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half.
Tighten up, fellas.
Darnay Holmes now from his end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And have hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys, they're tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. So from the 26-yard line, here's a 2nd and 5. They'll run it again with Barkley. Down the sideline he goes. Inside the 20. Saquon Barkley. Touchdown, Giants. Saquon Barkley. 74 yards. And the Giants are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by York is up and good. And it's now 21-7. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They make their second half debut here, and things are looking a little bit tougher now. You give up the points there, Charles, that touchdown drive on the other side. So now it's a 2-score game here. Got to be careful.
They certainly do, and I'm just wondering at halftime if those guys just looked into each other's eyes and realized what they've got to get done and come out a little bit more charged up, because if they don't get some kind of points here, that next drive, that could make this a 3-possession game.
Now a first down carry by Jones.
Good fucking save.
Brings him down.
Consecutive positive runs for him on the last two snaps. He certainly appears to be trying to put the offense on his back and just move them down the field, but his number is called. The way he's running it, I keep going back to him.
On second down, it's Vaughn. And only a couple there as he'll take this up to the 47. We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done, because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Give him 18 on that one, and it's a Dallas first down.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
What the fuck are you talking about?
So the drive takes them into Giants territory now, 1st and 10 at the 34. An inside give to Jones. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
You got to figure the further they fall behind, the more you think that they'll get away from the run. They're trying to stick with it, but the results, they just aren't there.
Looking at a 2nd and 11 now after the loss.
Go back.
Up the middle, Jones. And he'll follow his blockers there all the way down to the 23-yard line. 54 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
That's how you get right up off of the mat, because on the last play, they stoned him in the backfield and dropped him for a loss. But he's the type of guy that scared me a little bit, because he's not daunted. Just got right back up, showed some confidence, and picked up a first down with his very next run.
And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. On the ground with Gould, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down.
And now you have to wonder, partner, at what point in time do they forget the running game? It's been a struggle so far in this one. I would think they'd have to start throwing it a little bit more.
Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Prescott from the gun.
Ooh.
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yes, let's make sure to give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They're giving him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal. Prescott down. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
And those two just have been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect him to have more completions to him in this game.
And his kick is right there. It's good. And that will get the disadvantage now back down to 11. So the response to that touchdown on the other side to begin the third quarter. Look, just 3 points, but still a response nonetheless.
You're exactly right about that, because I think you needed to answer back with something, even though it's not six. Just enough to send the message that says, hey, we're not going away.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30, right about the 29. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated grooves. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles' defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Here's a second and nine now from the 29. They'll go to Barkley again. There he goes, left side.
Curse, you slow as a bitch, Curse, for sure.
And all the way in, touchdown, New York. Saquon Barkley, already his second touchdown here this opening weekend. And the Giants are closing in on a winning start to the year as they extend their fourth quarter lead. Extra point by York is up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener. But this has just been a performance, to be frank, not to be proud of here as they trail big in this fourth quarter. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Here's Prescott. That one caught along the sideline. Did he stay in? Yes, he did. But hang on here. A penalty marker is on the field. A penalty accepted, and they move the ball forward. Mickey. A first down throw for Prescott.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Now a second and 10. From the shotgun, a give to Jones. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and 9 looming.
Brandon, you're a big lover of music. How about what you just saw there? This is what I call playing the piano for a defensive lineman. The ability to move laterally up and down the line of scrimmage. How about the way he just flowed and got to the outside part of the field and made that play?
The Cowboys on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This is 3rd and 9.
Ooh,
and he can't get away from the pressure the Giants get there. And award that sack to Boogie Basham.
We all know he's one of the better quarterbacks in the league, but definitely not today. His team trailing by multiple touchdowns and a late sack. Just a parting gift from the defense for him to take back to the locker room with him.
Here's Brian Anger now as he'll kick it away for the second time. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. Not good at all. Punt of just 24 yards there. And the Giants will begin this drive in good shape, 1st and 10. First down carry for Barkley. Andrew Thomas, former first rounder from Georgia, called for the penalty there. The tight end in motion right here. They'll try and run some clock here with Barkley. And he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about 5. Good gain there on first down. It keeps them in a running situation probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front. Good blocking. Nice hole for him. Ends up picking up nice yardage. Stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
And not in any rush offensively. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. Man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. Touchdown, Giants. Jalen Hyatt with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Giants are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead. Charles, a well-drawn-up play, beautifully executed. And look at the scoreboard and where we're at in the second half. They are on their way to a 1-0 start to this season.
Exactly what every team in the league dreams of, winning your season opener, getting off to that good start, and building confidence for the rest of the season.
The kicking team out there for the Giants as they will send this one away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And no doubt this is not the way that they had hoped to open their season. Thoroughly outplayed here in front of the national audience. A little bit of space there for the first down run as that's going to get him about 5 yards.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run? Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. Here's Prescott. That is caught. Finding room in midfield. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Prescott yet again. That's into the hands of Gallup over the middle. And a six-yard gain gets him right around the 43. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Here is third down and 4. Looking to throw. Prescott. And a throw there going to be incomplete. Another pass attempt, another incompletion. You figure defensively, you're in the fourth quarter here. You've held the team under 100 yards passing. You've done your job.
Especially in today's NFL, which is truly a pass-first league.
We needed that point, boy. He let us down.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Desperation time. Prescott on fourth. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by Xavier McKinney. And the Giants are going to get the football here at their own 40-yard line.
Always next week, fellas.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Well, they don't really need the points here, Charles, given what we're looking at on the scoreboard, but they've scored on three consecutive possessions, three consecutive drives, and I'm sure that they would like to keep that streak going here and continuing to pour it on.
And things have gotten that way in the NFL, haven't they, partner? Because in the old days, people would, you know, they'd get off the gas a little bit, right? But now, people continue to accelerate. But we'll see what they decide to do as they come out for this one. But the way that this game has gone, they've got to be awfully happy with their execution overall.
Bounce on the other side of midfield at the 45. Wow, and even 200 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
We owe these motherfuckers, boy.
Here we go.
Clock counting down toward 40 seconds as they take the knee. And they will take a knee here. Now this
This was not just the
practice in the season,
but this was a division game here in week one. And to come through with a 1-0 start against a division opponent gives you a little something extra heading forward for the rest of the season.
Yeah, let's pile it all into one game, right? Opening the season, and you open within the division. You knew the motivation was going to be there on both sidelines. One just executed better and earned the win.
So for the Giants, they start the campaign with a victory in front of an enthusiastic home crowd for a Sunday night. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Arizona Cardinals. Meanwhile, for Dallas, they go down to defeat here in the opener. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.
I'll be back on this motherfucker in another league or on some Call of Duty. Holler back, check with the channel. Love, peace, and happiness.